My name's Stuart, I'm watching Morris TV.
So Johnny got the win against Darlington RA last time. Was that giving the whole group a lift, do you think?
Yeah, definitely. It was a very good performance. I mean, they're not six in the table for no reason. Obviously, they're a good side. They work really hard. So it was going to be a tough game going up there. I mean, the pitch was quite a tough pitch to play on as well. But I think I said to you before, the two lads that were brought in, you know, Ben Ryden and Chris Renshaw, they give everybody a big lift. And yeah, it was a really good performance and got a deserved 3 points.
A bit of a new formation as well, wasn't it? I mean, you played Lee Maitland up top and Barry Smith just off and with Paul out wide. Was that something that you're looking to sort of continue, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, like I said before as well, you know, different games, you know, different systems, you know, but we thought going there, you know, after the defeat, the three defeats in a row, we wanted to be harder to beat. So we played like a 4-2-3-1, you know, had two sitting midfielders, and Chris Renshaw and Chris Locke, and they looked after the back four, you know, tried to plug gaps and whatnot, and they give the back four good protection. And then we had the three lads in front of them, you know, Paul Kane to the left, James Talbot to the right, and Barry Smith just behind Lee Maitland. You know, played Lee Maitland there for a reason. He's a big, strong lad. You know, if you're going to play one up top, you need a big, strong lad who's going to hold the ball up for. And I thought Lee done that very well, which gave Barry the chance to get in between the fullbacks and the centre half on either side. It gave James Talbot and Paul Kane a chance to go and support him. You know, so yeah, I thought it worked well. You know, and especially the two sitting midfielders, you know, that give a lot of protection and discipline in front of the back four, which is what we needed. You know, to stop conceding goals.
Just frustrating that you don't have a game this weekend now. That you don't have the chance to sort of continue that momentum.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's the whole place was buzzing after the game. You know, the lads had said, you know, it was probably the best performance for the season, where everybody worked really hard for the 90 minutes. You know, so yeah, you want to play straight away. We'd love to have a game, you know, on Tuesday or Wednesday of this week, but it's not to be. Obviously, we'll have a free week on Saturday, and then we will prepare for the quarter final next week against Birtley.
Is that going to be the biggest game of the season so far, do you think, against Birtley?
Well, I think the next game is always the biggest game, isn't it? You know, whenever you play a game, it's always the next game is the biggest one, but yeah, by no stretch of the imagination, this is the biggest game of the season for, because we're not going to get promoted, we're not going to get relegated. You know, we're sitting safe, nothing's going to happen in that department. So it's a chance for the club to get some silverware. You know, we've never had any silverware for a few seasons now. I've just said to the lads there, you know, if we get to a final, it'll be good support behind us. You know, they'll get looked after. So let's try and go everything we can to get this result on Wednesday and get through the next round. You know, I think we've got I think this is what team Northumbria in it, Billingham Town and Norton. So yeah, there's some good sides in there, but we need to get past this first hurdle of Birtley, who've already beat with the season. You know, so we need to go there and put a performance in like we did against Darlington RA, and if we can do that, you know, we've shown over the season on our day we can beat anybody, and hopefully Wednesday is going to be our day.
And Birtley obviously beat you 3-1 in November. Did you learn plenty from that game?
Well, yeah, I mean, you learn everything every time you play the opposition. You know, I mean, they've got a good side, and they've got a few lads from the college. You know, they're quite strong up front. But I mean, most of the teams in this league are much of a muchness. You know, apart from go to the top sides where they're paying the extra money to get the top quality centre forward who win the games for you. You know, Birtley's much of a muchness in this league. You know, and if we go there with the right attitude, you know, like we did on Saturday against Darlington RA, then we'll certainly get through the next round and get in the hat for the semi final.
Been missing Dave Malloy and Craig Roberts among a few others recently. Are they going to be sort of fighting back for that game, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, Davey Malloy, he's obviously he's been really bad off with the flu, so hopefully Davey's going to be back for Wednesday. And Craig Roberts, like I said the last time I spoke to you, they had said 2 to 3 weeks, so we're hoping he's going to be okay, but we won't rush it. You know, obviously we've got a good strong squad there, we've brought a few players in of late, so we'll have a good squad going down there on Wednesday night, and hopefully we've got Davey Malloy back, hopefully we've got Craig Roberts back as well.